Hello, YouTuber. So, I have not seen a good review of this scope, so I thought let's make a review, or basically some my personal opinion and some basic stuff regarding the scope. As many of you asked me what type of scope you had, or what is that, it's really nice, and can you write something more about it or say something more about it. So here it is. This is BelOMO PKA red dot scope. A Soviet type of scope that is cheap, gets the work done, and it is really nice, and I can say simply awesome. It's nothing more I can say. You can see it comes with this really nice pouch in some camouflage that you can put your belt, or put it on your belt, and when you don't have to have the scope on your gun, you will simply remove it and put in the into the pouch. But I don't personally wear it because this velcro is really weak. It gets really easily opened, and I would be afraid that I would lose the scope, even that it's half kilo heavy, and I would certainly notice it that I have something fall in the ground, but still. And also you can see it's this already getting broken here, so it's not necessarily good quality of the pouch. So let's see what you will get when you buy this scope. Okay, so basically you will get the scope, the I don't know how to say this in English. Basically, when the sun is lighting your scope, this will make a shade, additional shade. So, it's not a kill flash, but it is something like on the SVD type of scope. You can move forward, and so you have a longer shade. You will get also this cleaning cloth. This was packed here, and you will get also some brush for particles, for removing particles. And here you will get some basic information on how to zero the scope, and also some basic information regarding different guns, how to zero it because of how the bullet will fall. After the firing, and some calculation and stuff. It is in Russian, so I don't understand it. And also the manual is in Russian, as you can see. Everything in Russian. And here in the back, you have some serial number and also the date of production. As you can see, it is 1st of April 2011. So I have 5 years old scope. Regarding the scope, as you can see on this adapter, I have added an acrylic glass to cover it from BBs, so it will not get damaged. This beautiful red air coated concealed lens, really beautiful, and also it covers me from the dirt because this glass I have, it is already really dirty, so. It's really nice. I wear it on the front, but you can also screw it on the back if you want. I don't know what will make a difference if you put it on the back, but because you can see it is really there is a lot of space until it will reach the lens, inside lens. So I wear it on the front. So this is the, I don't know if it's called Saiga mode, and basically this is the basic AK mode, because you have also the Tiger mode, that is SVD type of mode, and the difference is in the stop pin. As you can see, the Saiga mode has the stop pin in the back, and the Tiger mode has the stop pin in the front, and also there is different in the size of the size of this mount, as the Tiger is a bit more down, and you could not be able to mount the Tiger Tiger PKA on AK due to this lens here. Yeah, I forgot in Slovak version that here is the lens you can replace. The lens, the light bulb that you can replace in case if it will get damaged. There are 8 levels of luminescence of the red dot. Red dot means that you will have this red dot. Is this working? Yeah, it is working, but don't. Okay, here it is. Red. Eight levels of luminosity. This red dot. And at the end, there is 9 position. It will again turn it off, so you can easily in the daytime move from 0 to 9 quickly. So it is really nice. What more to say? The zeroing gets through by these knobs. They are covered with metal caps, so we will not accidentally unzero your gun. The clicking is really sniff, snappy, really nice. It's not that easy. Okay. Batteries, they are going batteries LR44. LR44, I think this is the correct. These are quite cheap. You can get this for $5, 10 pieces. To the gun, they are going two pieces. To the scope, they are going 2 pieces, like here. You can see. Also some adapter here. This is some o-ring. I recommend greasing this o-ring, so I will do it now. I will forget then. The scope is waterproof, so you don't need to worry about getting water on it, because this is genuine, not some Chinese replica. Regarding the seeing from it, it's really amazing. I must say that the clarity of the picture is unbelievable. Really, if you haven't had a genuine scope yet in your hands, when you first will have a genuine scope in your hands, you will not want to come back to the Chinese knockouts and rip-offs and cheap scopes from AliExpress and stuff. Because really the genuine stuff is genuine stuff. It is something unbelievable. I can tell a funny story that happened to me when I got this scope first time. I turned it on, 9 level, and I was watching through a window in my apartment, and people were walking, and simply and one man came directly above my red dot. And he turned onto the window, and I was almost scared. What, he sees my red dot or something? And it was really funny, because it really looks like, when you look through it, that somebody is pointing with the red dot on the wall or something. When you're watching, it's that really nice clarity, amazing. It feels so natural. I don't know, this is maybe the correct word. It feels so natural looking through it, and simply it is great. I can only recommend it. Only stuff that there are some cons, is the weight of it. It weighs 0.5 kilo, and you have a gun that weighs 3.5 kilo and put additional 0.5 kilo on it. It really, the gun is becoming so heavy. Second thing is that this body thickness is so thick that it is interfering with your line of sight for the battlefield. This is the second thing, and third thing, what? Oh, the battery life. Yeah. The battery life. If I would leave it turned on the full position, it will be working non-stop, I think, for 2 days, maybe more a bit. but not like on the Western scopes when you leave it on and you can, it can work basically almost on 1 year or few months with no issues. This is not the thing with this Soviet scope. On the upgraded version, it is totally different electronics, but on this stuff, this is old design and the power consumption is really high. But I can say I have heard these batteries from last year, I think, yeah. 1.5 years almost, not few months plus minus. And still the batteries are quite strong and I can say I had it tuned on almost for one whole day, 24 hours, if I count all the actions. When I didn't shoot the gun, I simply put it on the off position, and when we started playing or I wanted shut the gun, I again turned it on the 9S. This is the best for the light environment, and you want to see the red dot clearly. So I can recommend you buying some spare batteries and simply put this on the backpack, and in case you will, the red dot will be really weak, and you will just replace the batteries and okay, again, be shooting for few days non-stop. So I think this is all that I wanted to comment and want to show you. Zeroing really easy. The casing is not that really scratch proof, but it will give really nice patina when you wear it. And if you think about it, this scope was in Afghan era, if I'm correct. It is amazing that 40 years or 30 years design still is used by day. And good thing with the Soviet scopes, these Russian made scopes, they are dirty cheap. They can go from 200 euro to 500 euro, 600 euro. Where the Western counterpart, they are 1000 euro to 8000 euro, depending on the type, of course. And yeah, there will be lighter and stuff, but this is for the purist and the people who enjoy Soviet and Russia stuff and the Russophiles and blah blah blah. This is the thing you want to have. It's really badass to have something written in Cyrillic on your gun. So, Cyrillic. So, okay, regarding the costing, I bought this, like I said, 1.5 years ago, before the sanctions started for Belarus and Russia. And I bought it for 180 euro from the eBay seller, Radaki, Radaki, if you want it, I will post in the comment section below where I bought it, and yeah, it was a really great price, because they are now going for 250-300 euro, if you compare it, they're up at the prices, and before the Ukraine conflict, they were even cheaper, they were around 100 euro. Well, maybe due to the conflict and people buying stuff, the prices skyrocket again. But this is a normal thing, I think also with the backlight magazines that were everywhere and cheap, and now they are really, really rare to find and they are really expensive. So, okay, we have this covered, and there are also a modification of PKA for Venezuela, PKAS. No, I don't know if that's correct, but Venezuela type is more on the right and this part is bigger and looks similar to it, same color, but you have it more in the center, not that offset, because when the Russians were inventing this, they thought that really genuinely, if you have it on your gun, your iron sights are here, and you have a scope like this. So if your scope will happen something like the batteries will die, you will simply eye on the under it, an eye on the iron sights, and you will be able still to see your target. This is really amazing, and I think this was really nice of them thinking about this kind of issue. Okay, so I think that is all. If you have any questions, please post in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed this review, small talk of this Russian Soviet type of scope PKA from BelOMO, Belarus. So I think there is not a single video regarding this scope, so now it is on the internet, it will be there for an ages to come. Okay, thanks again for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, see my other videos, and I hope you enjoy it, and see you later. Okay.